Hi, my name is Elaine King. I'm an expert in family governance, financial education, and wealth planning. Today we're going to talk about those headaches that entrepreneurs have. And I know there are tons of them, but I can just think of three that I want to share with you and maybe give you a couple of tips on how to mitigate some of them. So the first one is accounting and cash flow. Let's face it, that's the number one headache of an entrepreneur. One of the tips that I have for that is to adopt from the get-go an accounting system. I could name a lot of them, you can just Google it and you can find it, but it is a good investment to systematize or have a system on your accounting process system. So think of this, a doctor usually doesn't charge for the patient. There's usually an accountant system, an accountant that charges, or somebody else. So try to separate that from your business. The second headache is unexpected catastrophes, accidents, floods, earthquakes, the loss of inflow of a spouse, or illness or sickness. So for those, I know as an entrepreneur, you're probably thinking, I need to allocate some funds, and the answer is yes. You need to invest in insurance, because one of the main reasons why businesses fail is because of lack of cash flow, and you do need to be preventive in this measure. And the third headache is unnecessary cash flow. I just said the word cash flow, and the cash flow comes again and again because you need to project every month, every year, and every quarter. Identify where the time is going, where you want the time to go, and where you want the money to be allocated. If you're starting a business, you also have to project the first year setup costs. And if you have a family business, you need to separate the capital expenditures from the non-capital expenditures. So cash flow, unnecessary and insurance, and have a system and processes in place. For more tips like this, my name is Elaine King. I'm an expert in family governance, financial education, and wealth planning.